closed. Did everybody receive the safety briefing while you're inside? Any questions at all? Everybody's good? Okay. And then Peter, you got that orange handle on the door over there. Just make sure not to accidentally bump it or pull it. If I need to pull, put you to work on your anniversary trip, I put you in for a bigger raise, okay? So we'll try, we'll try to skip all that, right? And as we take off, I do need to turn the microphones off on takeoff and then also approach back into the airport by FAA regulations. Throughout the flight, they'll be off and on. There's a lot of voices in my head. I think they're real. They seem pretty nice. They're all real. So there's a lot of voices. There's a lot of helicopters out here flying around. So same time we're talking, I hear every one of those guys. So throughout the flight, I may actually turn the mics off in mid-sentence or something like that. Guys, don't take that personal. Just give me a second. Let me deal with those guys as soon as I can. Always safety before the tour. That's my number one priority, of course. And other than that, if you guys are excited, ready to go, we'll turn the mics off, start rolling. Sound good? All right.
Sounds good.
Give me just a second. As soon as I get our clearance out of here, I'll give you a heads up.
Don't worry. Be happy. Hey, I give you my phone number. When you worry, call me. I make you happy. Don't worry. Be happy. Ain't got no cash, ain't got no style, ain't got no gal to make you smile, but don't worry, be happy. Cause when you worry, your face will frown, and that will bring everybody down, so don't worry, be happy, don't worry, be happy now. Don't worry, be happy. Don't worry, be happy. Don't worry.
All right, everybody, let's go fly.
Don't worry, be happy. Now there is this song I wrote. I hope you learned it note for note like good little children. Don't worry.
Still have the mics turned off for just a few more minutes, but once the tower releases me legally, I'll be able to turn those back on. Everybody doing okay so far? That's good? Yeah? Guys, you got your cruise ship over here. I wish we could make turns, but right in between two runways right here, so they don't let us ever do the turns right here, unfortunately. So if anybody gets a good picture of that, I'm sure Fred and Marilyn would appreciate that. I'll make sure to get it on the video as well, though. Well, you do have one of our lighthouses over here. There's only two of those on this island, and that one you really have to have a four-wheel drive to get out to it. It's a rough road. I see the rental cars get out there sometimes, and they don't usually make it back. You guys are parked in the Willy Willy Harbor. That's somewhat the lifeline for us in a lot of ways. All of our fuel comes in by ship right there, and then, of course, all of our cruise ship's dock right there. Probably get a little wind bump as we go across this ridge right here. We usually do. I promise I do not take any chances with you guys whatsoever, but I only always get little winds here and there. I'll try to give you heads up on those when I know about them. So you guys like movie stuff where things are filmed at? Yeah, a lot of cool stuff. Yeah, see the river to the right. It's called the Hula'ia River. Look. Remember Indiana Jones and the scene where Indiana Jones was came out of the jungle, swam out to the seaplane, he took off, had all the snakes on board? That was filmed on that river where they took off. Remember seeing that when I was younger, thinking, ah, that's pretty cool. Not the snakes part, I don't like those, but no snakes in Hawaii. And this loneliness won't leave me. And then you guys see this ridge right here in front of us, that high point right there. This is the Ha'upu Ridge. If you saw MASH, you've seen that part of it before. Right when MASH comes on, the music's playing, the credits are rolling, and there's two helicopters come in to land at the base right there. And so that's the mountain in the background. It happened really quick, only about 2-3 seconds. We get these little bumps till we get over this ridge and it calms down. Yeah, so all this land right here on the in front of us on the left, this is called Kipukai. It's private property owned by one family. If you ever saw the movie The Descendants with George Clooney, that was the family piece of land in that movie. So that's where they filmed that. So George Clooney was standing on that ridge to the right and looking over the property right here. But a lot of that was filmed up in Hanalei Bay as well. But the movie is loosely based on this family that owns this. And so it looks like, though, they're probably going to turn this over to Kauai in the near future with the one stipulation they never develop it. So that could be really cool. It could be a state park. We don't have access to this right now except by boat. So unless you have a boat, you don't get to come in here. Probably get a little bump right here, too, and then it'll calm down again. I got a slow boy. All right, guys and girls, just got released from the tower, so the microphones are on now. You guys feel free to ask questions, sing karaoke, whatever you like.
I can sing for you.
Yeah, I love it. I say, that's the kind of tours I like, man. I like enthusiastic people.
There's so much land that is, like, undeveloped and beautiful here.
It's a special place in a lot of reasons, Peter, in my opinion, but that is one of the things that's really special. Each island's very different, right, if you guys go to each island. Each one's very different. Kauai's really known for being more outdoorsy and really country. It's more of a country farming community in a lot of ways, too. If you ever come back and you want to stay on Kauai, this community over here to the left, that's called Poipu. And so each island's going to have a sunny side and a rainy side. This is our sunny side. Your south, southwest side is usually the sunny side. Poipu, especially in the wintertime, that's where I would recommend. The wintertime's our rainy season, so we get more rain. So you're going to get less of that over here. Summertime, not as important, you know, which side of the island you stay on, but it's always going to be sunnier on this side. This pond over here to the left, it's the largest reservoir in Hawaii. It's called Waitā, which means water, water in two different languages. It was built back in the 1800s. This was all sugar fields, right, at one time. So this was all sugar fields, so they use that for irrigation for the sugar fields. That's all gone. It's cheaper to grow that in other countries now. So now it's just a good place to bass fish. So. We've got no native freshwater fish in Hawaii, but we do have a peacock bass, the smallmouth bass, and then a largemouth bass, and then even some rainbow trout here in Hawaii, or on this island in Kauai.
Now, are people allowed to hike all this?
No, not really all this. This is all private farmland community, and so, yeah, all this. Just a second. You can see the farms right here. Now, these are tree farms. This is our second biggest crop on the island. So they grow these trees simply to harvest them. They'll cut these down. They end up putting them into an incinerator. They'll burn them. They produce about 8% of the island's power that way. So it's definitely not the most efficient way to make power, right? But sometimes when you're isolated like this, you have to do that. But it's a pretty clean fuel. You almost get zero emissions by burning those. So the whole power structure on this island has really changed in the last 4 years drastically. 4 years ago, we had 85% of our power came from a diesel generator. So not the cleanest, right? Now we have at least 50% of the island's power comes from the Tesla solar farms. And so big changes, but electricity bills still go up and up. Nothing's changed on that. License to fly.
How many square miles is the island?
544 square miles, so yeah. This property right here, did anybody read or hear about the family that owns 51,000 acres here? No. So there's one family where we came into the mountains, as far as you guys can see and way past that, belongs to one family.